Hey Capricorn, welcome to Live, Laugh, Love, Hear It. Today we're delving into who's thinking about you and why, okay? This can play out past, present, or future, so take it how it resonates if it resonates for you, okay? I'ma just say, because I saw it in the pre-shuffle, Capricorn, I see the person that's thinking about you, they're finna race towards you, okay? They made some type of decision. This person could have made like some type of decision online, okay? And they don't care who see, but a past person they were dealing with could have seen. Yeah, hangman. Somebody's caught up on the person that's thinking about you. Okay? But not only that, while someone's caught up on the person that's thinking about you, they're caught up on you. Okay? That makes sense. Smash your like button. All right. I want to say thank you for all of the likes, subscribes, tips, donations, bookings, support of any kind to the brand, as well as the channel is greatly appreciated. Know that any and everything that has to do with Live, Laugh, Love, Tear It, or myself will be down below in the description box. Okay, Capricorn, who's thinking about Capricorn and why, Spirit? Please and thank you. Okay, somebody that's getting ready to be sneaky. Why are they getting ready to be sneaky, Spirit? Please and thank you. The World card. So this person about to try to come in and like... Capricorn, I want to say like this is like the love of your life and all this shit. But this is a karmic, you know? It's like this person is trying to sneak back into your life so that they can make it into another cycle and another season in your life. You know, this could be a fixed energy. Leo, Taurus, Scorpio, or Aquarius. They could be a Libra, Gemini, Aquarius as well. This person is trying to sneak back in. They're trying to find ways. Ooh-wee. And this person could potentially try to get you pregnant, or they could try to get pregnant with the Star card here to try to get your attention and try to get you to focus back on them again. Okay, Capricorn, there's somebody here that wants your attention bad, but they don't really have anything to offer with this baby-ass Page of Cups. Like, they doing all this sneaking to complete a cycle with you, to follow you into your next stage of life. And this person really doesn't have much to offer you. Yeah, with the Three of Cups here. In fact, this person is involved with somebody else. That's why they got to sneak back into your life. Yeah, this person is trying to have their cake and eat it too. They don't want to miss out on anything. Okay, they want to test the waters with everything here. And there's that Knight of Swords racing in to say something to you. But I feel like this is something sneaky that this person comes to say. Okay, Ace of Cups, they want you to... okay, they could be racing forward, love bombing you. But look what they have to offer, though. Yeah, Page of Pentacles comes out. Because they're involved with somebody, third party energy here with the Three of Cups. So they're coming in telling you like, yeah, Capricorn, I can offer you the Ace of Cups. But at the same time, you're going to quickly see that this person doesn't really have much to offer. Like, you're going to have to wait and see, wait and find out to see how things go. But I'm going to tell you now, this person has a third party and they thinking about you. With the Justice card here, could be a Libra. Okay. This person is going to get karma for this. The Tower card. Something comes in unexpected. Okay. What's unexpected? Let me see what just flew out here. The Emperor in reverse. Wow. So why the Emperor in reverse? So it comes out that this person is a karmic, okay? Something happens where they get all in their head. I feel as though this person may lose a job or something. If they have an entrepreneurship, I see their finances tumbling, or I see their business tumbling, okay? This person is really in their head about this, okay? So much that they probably have to withdraw from you. Look, they're putting their guard down now. This is like that type of energy when you get drunk and you're like, I promise God I'm not drinking again. You know, this is that type of energy. They're so stuck on you. They're trying to see how you moving and stuff. Like, what are you doing? And they feel as, okay, this is the energy of someone. They got a lot going on. Okay, Capricorn, the person that's thinking about you. They're gonna go through something for just like fucking with you, you know, like trying to deal with you, knowing that they don't really have anything to offer you, knowing that they just gonna still have a third party, have a cake and eat it too, right? So this person is not only dealing with a third party, but then something is gonna arise with their finances or with their career. Okay, and this person is going to feel like a way to get closer to you without even thinking they're going to lower their guard. They're so fixated on what are you thinking? How are you thinking, Capricorn? Okay, Five of Wands energy. Why are Five of Wands? Page of Swords. See, they're going to see something here. Magician card. You over here manifesting. Ooh, Two of Pentacles, they see you dealing with somebody else, and now they have regret. This person has regret. You could have lived with this person. You could have been married to this person. Nine of Cups, they could have really been doing them. Look, you could have been married to this person. Smash your like button if you was married to this person, Capricorn, or you were just like in a family dynamic with them. You all live together. Maybe you talked about higher commitment, okay? Maybe you were just in a commitment, in a relationship, and you had children together, okay? But this person had their cake and eat it too. And because of that, it rained on that family dynamic. It rained on that connection, right? With the Devil card. The Devil card and the Four Pentacles. This person began to hold on to their ways, you know? That's this person's energy, doubling, like juggling, really. But I almost want to be like doubling back, you know? Back and forth. That's how this person does. Yeah, with the Knight of Pentacles. And this person may like go out of your life and take a long time to come back. Then they come back. I don't know. I don't really like this energy, you know. This person could have really been trying to oppress you and trying to keep you stuck or stagnant. Smash that like button if that's you. This person could be a Cancer. Okay, Capricorn, this person could be a Cancer. Smash that like button if they are. Or they're like on that cusp. You know, Cancer, Leo, cusp. Okay, here we have fated to suffer. This is what you can't see. This person is fated to go through some karma. Not only that, I am getting to that this person, they really get down on themselves. They really have like this victim consciousness, especially when things start to get on top of them. And they could really be having that behind closed doors. It says today for tomorrow. So this person is already planning, you know, things that they can do today that will get them closer to where they want to be at tomorrow, okay? So that's where that kind of Seven of Swords manipulative, sneaky energy comes in as well, too, because this person over here plotting, okay? Yeah, and there's that obsession energy because this person is a little bit obsessed, all right? It says hiding your true self. I feel like this person is wearing a mask. What else popped out? Peaceful among thorns. See, this is somebody that's like a drama starter, too. They wear a mask. Okay, yeah, it says fragmented underneath here. This wanted to show itself as well. Okay, this is somebody that really needs to heal themselves, and they really could be running towards you, Capricorn, so that you could pick up the pieces and heal them. Okay, and then they'll be right back off, right through the door as soon as their wounds have healed, and they'll be back dealing with a third party, okay? But that's who's thinking about you. Let's go ahead and delve deeper into their energy, please, and thank you, Spirit. Bad health. This person could be really stressed the fuck out, and it could be affecting their health. I'm hearing high blood pressure for someone. For others of you all, it could be an STD. What else? Official person, but yet they're still raining around here, like, you know, walking around here like they shit don't stink, and near this official person. But the whole time, their health is suffering, okay? We have false person. This person is wearing a mask, or they could have been dealing with a third party that was. We also have message of concern that this official person here has some type of health scare, some type of bad health here, okay? Something that is of concern, okay? Capricorn, I want you to be all of the way aware of this. Please and thank you. We have marriage. Some of y'all could have been in a marriage with this person. But if you weren't, this is just this. If they are married, this is a newer connection. And you maybe you dealt with this person before, you know, but it wasn't nothing too deep. Okay. that's for a small percentage of you. Smash that like button if it is. But I feel like there was some type of higher commitment here. I feel like there was some type of promise to each other. Like, okay, we're going to get married. Okay, we're going to do this. Okay, we're going to do that. You know, some type of planning, okay? I feel like this is a mature masculine energy. But at the same time, I feel like this person has been hiding a lot of things that's been going on with them, okay? So how is this going to pan out? Please and thank you. It says you're very close to achieving your goal. Okay, so this person could feel like they're very close to, you know, sealing a deal with you, Capricorn, okay? And if you're trying to achieve a goal here, I feel like you're closer to that more than ever. Here we have you are good enough. Full moon in Virgo. I really feel like this has a lot to say about you, okay? Well, you're really stepping into your self-worth, Capricorn, okay? You could have really recently broken away from a karmic toxic relationship, okay? And I really feel like you're stepping into your own power, really manifesting anew here, okay? Some of you all could have recently moved. Others of you all are just taking a leap of faith when it comes to really working hard, trying to achieve a goal here. We also have don't let your past hold you back, self-node. So you're definitely transitioning from the past, Capricorn. That's what I'm seeing. And moving towards a new beginning. I really feel like there were some obstacles that had to be overcome with this person. This person could have been a tyrant. I don't like to throw the word narcissist around, but there is some type of narcissistic behavior here where this person could have been really trying to control your life. What you do, how successful, you know, that you are, your income coming in and out. This person really could have wanted you to be codependent on them while at the same time having their cake and eat it too. Not really grounding anything with you, but giving you those promises. All right. Bottom deck is hold your vision. All right, Capricorn. I feel as though smash that like button if you want something here. Okay. And you're trying to achieve that goal. Know that you are very close to doing so. And for part of the deck here, we have emotions are running high. So there was just a recent super moon here. For me filming this, I believe it was yesterday. It was on a Thursday and it was the Sturgeon super moon, last super moon of the year. Okay. I feel as though your emotions have been kind of everywhere. Okay. You've been wondering like, damn, am I going in the right direction? Am I doing what I need to do? Capricorn. Yes, you are. And you just need to hold tight to that vision. All right. I really see you overcoming a lot of obstacles and really letting go of a past karmic cycle. All right. So if this message resonated with you, smash that like button. If you want to see more reads like this one, smash that like button. Thanks for your love and support as always. Until then, peace and love.